No two farms are alike, and no two farms have the same goals. It's sometimes like a puzzle. How are we going to expand this farm in a logical manner that's also not going to break the bank or put them in hock with the environmental regulatory agencies? My name is Tim Terry. I am the Regional Farm Strategic Planning Specialist with the Harvest New York Group. What that means is I work one-on-one with farms, big farms, little farms, everything in between, on how they're going to grow their farmstead. In other words, trying to keep them economically and environmentally sustainable. We just completed a project at the end of last year. It was a small farm. It was destined to be another ag statistic. The older generation was in their 60s, but they still felt they had a lot of time and energy left to continue farming, but not in the labor-intensive manner that they were doing it. We had an opportunity with some different grants that became available, and we transitioned them into a brand new state-of-the-art compost bedded pack system with a robotic milker.
My name is Lester York. My wife's name is Cindy. The name of our farm is Whispering Winds Farms Organic Dairy. The reason that we wanted to do a new facility here is that we had a facility that was built in 1956 in a tie stall barn, and my wife and I do most of the milking and the chores. So we were trying to find a more efficient way of taking care of the animals.
And it frees us up to have more family time that we really long for.
Yeah.
Because our family is so big and it's important to us. We have no retirement thoughts at all. Retire to what? This is a lifestyle. It is a business, but it's a lifestyle. It's our way of life.
So we went about talking to several people at Empire Farm Days about robots. So we thought that we would look at this and see if it would help us in our situation. So I got a hold of Cooperative Extension and NRCS and Soil Conservation, all the different programs to help us. And so we went from the Stone Ages to landing on the moon, how that changed our situation here. We went to a TMR feeder. We went to automatic manure system. We have a robotic milker that is doing the milking for us. We have a Juno, and what it does is pushes the feed up to the cows every hour of the day. And then we also have the automatic scraping system. And that's one of the things we both wanted to have, because our cow's feet are clean all the time. And we run it on the hour. And with that, it helps keep the manure away from it. It helps what they call somatic cells, so they have good clean milk.
And they also have a groomer. And they love it. It is hilarious. That is probably one of my very favorite things to watch them do. We built the barn with the idea of them being comfortable. Cow comfort was all about what we wanted.
And I think we're taking care of 70 cows easier than we did 45.
It's easier, but you have to think differently now. It's new for us. It's a different kind of managing.
Sometimes you have to come out in the middle of the night at 3 o'clock in the morning, and that's not fun. But the amount of work that we've saved with the cows getting the food pushed up, the manure being scraped by itself, composted bedded pack, we only rototill that once a day, and the milking process where they're being milked right now, you know. It's paying for itself. It allows us to do the farming that we're supposed to better. Cooperative Extension helped us the most on this whole plan. Tim Terry came in, helping to design the barn and drawing pictures. He was a liaison between our carpenters at times, the people with the milking systems, and he helped it go a lot smoother. I don't know if we would have done it without him. And I think robotics is going to be the new thing in farming, because of the labor situation. It's hard to get good labor. And this has been a labor saver. And we're hopefully we made this a modernized farm, so it will bring the younger generation to want to do it instead of just being all hard labor We're hoping to make this an organic dairy farm that's viable so they would want to stay here. It's making more milk and it's helping pay for itself. So I think over the long run, it'll be a very good thing, and hats off to Tim Terry and Cooperative Extension.